Around the planet, at any given moment, there are between 40 and 55 volcanoes actively erupting. Among these volcanoes, no two eruptions are alike. Thus, to best understand the hazards an eruption might pose, it is important to be able to identify the type of eruption which is ongoing. This video will briefly discuss the 14 types of volcanic eruptions and what types of volcanoes most frequently produce them. The most common type of volcanic eruptions occur in the vast oceans of the planet and are referred to as submarine eruptions. At great depths, the significant water pressure makes it near impossible for any sort of explosive volcanic activity to occur after a few hundred meters below sea level. The majority of submarine eruptions are characterized by gentle lava effusion and a white column of superheated water, steam, minor amounts of ash, and volcanic gases which rise to the surface. A very similar eruption which occurs in locations such as the Andes, Alaska, Kamchatka, or Iceland are subglacial eruptions. Subglacial eruptions almost entirely occur underneath a thick ice sheet, and many times the eruption column never breaks the surface of the ice. One way to know that a subglacial eruption is ongoing is due to a large sudden flood of glacial water termed a jökulhlaup. One example of a subglacial eruption was the 1996 eruption of Grímsvötn, which released 3 cubic kilometers of water in a massive flood. However, if a submarine eruption occurs at depths of less than 50 meters, it creates an explosive eruption. At these depths, magma explosively interacts with the surrounding water, generating a series of short black ash-rich explosions alongside a central white plume in what is termed a Surtseyan eruption. On land, the most peaceful eruption type is known as an Icelandic eruption. This type of eruption is characterized by a lengthy fissure or crack in the ground which magma gently erupts from and spills out onto the sides. The lava is then funneled to whichever direction is downslope, frequently forming rivers of molten rock. Icelandic-style eruptions almost universally involve low silica basaltic magma and originate at or near divergent plate boundaries or rift zones on the planet, such as near Lake Baikal in Russia or central Iceland. A similar eruptive type, termed a Hawaiian eruption, occurs when instead of a fissure system, volcanic activity commences at either the summit of a shield volcano or a flank vent. In this type of eruption, lava is emitted alongside occasional small fragments of ash out of a vent via a tall fountain of material, which then falls back to the ground and gently flows downhill. If basaltic magma instead has a higher gas content, it can create the lowest magnitude of what can be correctly considered an explosive eruption. In a so-called Strombolian eruption, fluctuating bursts of volcanic gases and small explosions propel fragments of lava high into the air and fling them up to several hundred meters distant. Moderate amounts of ash are also emitted from the erupting vent in a process which is particularly loud. Strombolian eruptions often result in the formation of cinder cones, such as witnessed during the 2021 eruption of La Palma and the Canary Islands. At stratovolcanoes, the most common type of eruption occurs when lava or related volcanic products temporarily clog an eruptive conduit. Pressure then builds up until an explosion occurs, ejecting a thick cloud of ash. This is what occurs during Vulcanian explosive eruptions, which are best identified via the small pyroclastic flows they produce. These Vulcanian explosions are separated by periods of relative inactivity, which last between a minute and 36 hours. However, a Vulcanian eruption can also occur when the side of a lava dome is unstable and blocks of it fall off, releasing pyroclastic flows. This is what occurred at Mount Unzen in 1991, and some of my colleagues refer to this as a Merapi-type Vulcanian eruption. This fact might surprise some people, but there is an entire class of volcanic eruptions which does not eject any lava. In phreatic eruptions, underlying magma stays at depth and heats nearby groundwater. The heated groundwater then flashes to steam, and since steam takes up more space than the same mass of liquid water, it triggers a powerful explosion. Phreatic eruptions may occur as unique events, but are most commonly witnessed in the early stages of a magmatic eruption. If a phreatic eruption is large enough, or if the magma triggering the eruption is quite shallow, small fragments of lava can be ejected in what is termed a phreatomagmatic eruption. Aforementioned Vulcanian and phreatomagmatic eruptions do not typically produce a sustained eruption column, but instead produce intermittent plumes. If an eruption does have a sustained plume, lasting on the order of several hours to days, it is a Plinian eruption. During Plinian eruptions, significant quantities of ash are ejected high into the atmosphere, often reaching the stratosphere. It is quite common for part of the eruption column to collapse downwards, creating long-traveling pyroclastic flows. If a sustained eruptive plume is less than 20 kilometers in height, it is a subplinian eruption. If it is greater than 20 kilometers, it is a plinian eruption. If a plinian eruption occurs through a water-rich layer of a lake or glacier, an eruption plume may have a whitish-gray color in what is called a Phreatoplinian eruption. And if an eruption with a sustained eruption column ejects more than 10 cubic kilometers of explosively erupted material, it is called an Ultra-Plinian eruption. The final type of volcanic eruption gets its namesake due to the famous 1902 eruption of Pelée in the Caribbean, a Pelean eruption. Pelean eruptions occur when large amounts of pressure and gases build underneath a volcano. After reaching a critical point, a powerful explosion occurs, often occurring to the side of a volcano in a lateral blast, or being heavily focused towards a single direction. This generates long-reaching pyroclastic flows, which travel much further than seen at most Vulcanian or Subplinian eruptions. At some point in the eruption, before, during, or after the peak explosive phase, a lava dome is often constructed. Thanks for watching. If you would like to request a specific topic, please leave a comment below. Additionally, I would like to thank my new patron, Shale Tree, for supporting this channel.